So, this came in the mail the other day. Actually, Mark from Editor's Keys reached out to me a few days ago and asked me if they could send me a keyboard. They didn't want money, they didn't ask for a dedicated video, they didn't even ask for a shout out. They just sent me one. Now that's a good way to do business. To return the favor, I wanted to feature it in one of my videos. So, what better way to feature an editor's keyboard than to do a shortcuts video? But before we get started, let's do a quick unboxing. Nobody got time to sit there and watch me open boxes. Hey guys, what's up? My name is Serge and welcome back to my channel. I've done a video before about basic keyboard shortcuts, so today we'll take a look at an updated list of 10 keyboard shortcuts you should be using in Final Cut Pro. First up is selecting clips in your browser. When in your media browser, clicking on a clip will select it. Use the up and down arrow keys to cycle between your clips. If you only want to select a specific part of a clip, place a skimmer on the frame you want to start and press I on your keyboard to set the start or the end point. Setting the skimmer on the end of your selection and pressing O on your keyboard will set the end or the out point of your clip. With your entire clip, or only a part of your clip selected, pressing the F key will favorite your clip. Pressing Ctrl F will switch your browser to only showing your favorite clips. Ctrl C will take you back to seeing all the clips again. If you have an entire clip, or just a specific selection you know you're not going to use in your project, you can reject them by pressing the Delete key. Pressing Ctrl H will hide your rejected clips. Once again, Ctrl C will take you back to seeing all your clips again. There's a few different ways to add your browser clips to your project timeline. With your entire clip, or just a section of a clip selected, pressing E on your keyboard will append edit that clip to the end of your timeline. To connect edit the selected clip to your timeline, with the clip selected, press Q. This will add your selection as a connected clip above your timeline, wherever your playhead is placed. To insert a selected clip into the middle of your timeline, place your playhead where you want to insert your clip and press W on your keyboard. This shortcut can be used to insert your clip between two clips or even into the middle of one of your existing clips. When ripple trimming your clips in the timeline, the trim to start and trim to end keyboard shortcuts can be a huge time saver. With a skimmer placed where you want your clip to start, Option left bracket key will trim the start of your clip to your skimmer. Option right bracket key will do the same, but ripple trim the end of your clip to the skimmer location. There's a few shortcuts that will help you adjust your clip appearance in your timeline. Command and plus sign will zoom in on your timeline. Command and minus sign will zoom out. Pressing Shift Z on your keyboard will fit your entire timeline to your window. As far as clip display options, Control Option 1 will show you only a large audio waveform of your clip. Control Option 2 will give you a large audio waveform and a small film strip. Control Option 3 will display clips with audio waveforms and film strips of equal size. Control Option 4 for small audio waveforms and large film strips. Control Option 5 for large film strips only. And Control Option 6 to see only the clip labels. The next few keyboard shortcuts will help you navigate your timeline. Pressing the right and left arrow keys will move your playhead ahead or back one frame at a time. Holding down the Shift key while pressing the right and left arrow keys will move your playhead ahead or back 10 frames at a time. Pressing the up arrow key will take your playhead to your previous edit. And the down arrow key will take you to your next edit. Holding down the Function key and pressing the left arrow key will take you to the start of your project. And Function and right arrow key takes you to the end of your project. If you need to change the speed of your clip, pressing Command R will bring up the Retime menu where you can change the speed of your entire clip. If you need to retime only a part of your clip, you can add a speed ramp by pressing Shift B. This will allow you to set two or more different speeds for one clip. Using this shortcut also adds a speed ramp to smooth out the transition between your speeds. If you have keyframed any parameters in your clip, the keyframe timing can be easily adjusted in the video animation window. With your clip selected, press Ctrl V to show video animation. This shows you your applied keyframes and you can adjust the timing of them by simply clicking and dragging any of the keyframes. pressing Ctrl-V again will hide the video animation window. To copy and paste specific attributes from one clip to another, select a clip with a modified attribute, press Command-C to copy it. Next, select the clip you want to paste it to, and press Shift-Command-V to paste attributes. In the pop-up window, select the attributes you want to apply to your second clip, and click Paste to apply them to the selected clip. This is very useful for color corrections, transform changes, or any other effects that change the appearance of your clip. Next up is the Command key. As I'm sure many of you know, there's a ton of shortcuts where you combine the Command key with other keys. But did you know holding down the Command key while adjusting parameters in your timeline gives you much more precision? For example, if trying to adjust the volume on a clip, you drag up or down the volume line in the audio waveform. But to get a precise level can be a little tricky. Holding down the Command key while adjusting volume lets you adjust it in much smaller increments, giving you way more control. And last on my list is the Option key. Just like the Command key, holding down the Option key also modifies many actions in Final Cut Pro. Holding down the Option key while clicking on a clip in your timeline will select your clip and move your playhead to that location. If you hold down the Option key while dragging your clip, Final Cut Pro will duplicate your clip and create a copy of it. In the audio waveform, holding down the Option key while clicking on the volume line will add a keyframe to your volume controls. Using keyboard shortcuts can save you a ton of time, but can be very overwhelming and hard to memorize. With the Final Cut Pro backlight keyboard from Editor's Keys, this process becomes much simpler because all these shortcuts and more are printed right on the keyboard. All it takes is a quick glance down, and the built-in backlight makes it very easy to see in dark environments. Once again, a huge thank you to Editor's Keys for sending me this keyboard to try out. If you'd like to see a full review of this keyboard, let me know in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you back here next week.